let me say, a word in defense of reason in dialogue with faith.
Because faith is that proof. Faith unites us to that substance.
But reason, in order to realize its full potential, needs the horizons revealed by and truths contained in the faith. And not just any faith, but the Catholic faith.
And so the trials of faith that we face are not proof that we might not be children of God. They're proof that we are, that He's disciplining us. He's putting us in over our heads to show us how weak we are so that we might discover how strong He is if we let Him. This is true for Abraham. This is true for his offspring. This is true all the way down through the ages until the present time. I want to just quote a little bit as I begin to wrap up from Pope Benedict. Because in this amazing encyclical, Saved in Hope, he clarifies something that is really crucial. The definition that you find in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. The RSV renders it, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. I memorized that back in high school. But it wasn't until I read this encyclical and then looked again at the Greek and realized that that's a really bad translation. That is derived not from the Greek, but from Martin Luther's rejection of the plain sense of the text. Pope Benedict writes, to Luther, who was not particularly fond of the letter to the Hebrews, the concept, the word used here, substance, meant nothing. What does Pope Benedict mean? That the definition of faith here is that faith is the substance of things hoped for, not merely the assurance. It isn't something that we're just kind of sure that we will eventually get. It is the substance of what we already possess. By faith, we are united to God as our Father, to Christ His Son, to the power of the Holy Spirit. By faith, we are united to the saints. By faith, we now share eternal life. By faith, the Holy Trinity comes to dwell within us. It isn't something that is just far off, but we're certain to get it. Faith, he says, is the substance of things hoped for. And as a result, we have a different understanding. Pope Benedict says it rather gently. This in itself is not incorrect, but it is not the meaning of the text. Because the Greek term used does not have the subjective sense of conviction, but the objective sense of proof and substance. He's not denying the fact that faith and hope go together, but he's pointing out how Luther collapsed hope into faith. This becomes the basis of the Reformation and so much confusion. Because what is the object of our faith? The Word of God. Whatever we find in the Word of God, we believe it because God is our Father and He has spoken and He can't deceive or be deceived. We're His children. We trust Him more than we trust our own logic and science. That's faith. Whatever we find in the Word of God, we know to be true, even if we can't prove it. Because faith is that proof. Faith unites us to that substance. And yet at the same time, it unites us to the very substance of what it is we hope for. Now, Luther had a different understanding. It wasn't the objective reality of God's mysteries that we are united to by faith. For Luther, it was the personal assurance of salvation. And so you sometimes find his descendants asking you, are you saved? And you will say, well, you know, I'm baptized. I am following Christ as a disciple. I am saved as a Catholic Christian through the grace of God, working by the sacraments, through the Holy Spirit. I'm being saved. I hope to be saved. No, do you have assurance? If you were to die tonight and go before God and He were to ask you, why should I let you into my heaven? Do you have total certainty that you will go to heaven? Well, I have faith. No, you must be certain. And what Pope Benedict points out is that you've just confused these two very distinct virtues. Faith knows to be true whatever God has spoken. Hope is what applies that to my own life. But Luther said, no, unless you know you're saved, you're not saved. And so this notion of assurance is what caused the eclipse of hope. We as Catholics have the certainty of faith that whatever God has revealed is true. But when it comes to our own salvation, it's not the same thing. Why? Because nowhere in the Bible do I ever read Scott Hahn's name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. If it was written in the Scriptures, I would have the certainty of faith because God's Word is the object of faith. What I do read is, whosoever believes shall not perish, but have everlasting life. But how do I know whether I believe? You know, they say, once saved, always saved, if you don't fall away. This is where the virtue of hope comes in. This is where the virtue of hope went out the window. Because faith unites us to the substance, the reality of God's own life. And yet hope is what operates through God's own power.